Hello, my name is Brad Larkin. I'm here today to explain how to use the Family Tree DNA Genetic Genealogy Test Kit. Today we're going to cover the 2017 version, which has some differences. In your packet from the lab, you'll get two or more swabs. So these are scrapers we're going to use to scrape your cheek. You have a little bag with a release form or permission slip you need to read, agree to, fill out, and sign. And you've got these test vials which contain preservative to preserve your sample on the way back to the lab. And also a mailer to mail it back. You've also got printed instructions from the lab which you should read. A welcome letter from Family Tree DNA, and you may or may not have an order form depending on how your test was ordered. So, the summary of this is that we're going to take this, scrape it in our cheek, open the vial, push the end of it into the vial, and then break it off. So that way the end that touched our cheek goes into the preservative without us touching it with our finger. Then we're going to screw the cap back on. That's the gist of this procedure. A few notes before you begin. Be sure that the kit number on your release form matches what's on the vials that you're going to submit to the lab. And also try to wait at least 1 hour after eating or drinking before you take your swab test. That helps get the maximum amount of your DNA on the kit, which also helps the sample last and be testable for the longest period at the lab.
Enter your name and sign the release form to get the most information about your genetic matches. Also, to the best of your knowledge, indicate your paternal ancestor and maternal ancestor's earliest known point of origin.
Okay, looking at the materials again, you've got your swabs. You could have a newer orange vial that screws off. Or you could have a red style screw off vial. If you have the type of vials that are attached to the top, that's an older style. You should see a different instructional video. Here we're taking a look at our swab. It's got two ends, a straight end, and then a rounded brush end that's got some roughness to pull the cells out of your cheek. That's on the end with the black line. To open it, you're going to start peeling from the handle end, peel it back about as far as we can go, and then be sure you grab it from the handle end and pull it out this way, because again, the black end's the end we're going to put in our mouth to take our sample. Okay, now it's time to actually do the scraping. What I like to do is to have the test vial already open and set down on a flat surface. That way I have both my hands free to use the scraper. What I'm going to do is put it in my cheek, against my cheek, not my tooth and gum, but against my cheek, and then I'm going to scrape up and down and do a rolling action to get all sides of the swab head coated in cheek cells.
You may feel a slight scratching or discomfort as you do this. It should not be an intense pain. Also, stay in the cheek area. Avoid getting up by the lips. The lab recommendation is to scrub your cheek for 30 to 60 seconds. The main point is to get good quality samples from your cheek because those cells are high in DNA.
I'm going to take my swab, black end on the roller end, put it in my cheek. Scrape up and down while doing a rolling motion.
We never want the head of the swab to touch anything other than the inside of our cheek with those DNA cells. Therefore, this technique demonstrates how to break the head off in the vial without anyone touching it. Put the swab head into the vial to about the level of the black line. Then, holding the vial firmly with one hand, start bending the handle until it snaps.
So it's going to bend a little bit first, and then it should break at the black line. Then I'm going to replace the cap, screw it down, give it just a little shake to coat it in the preservative, and put it in my bag to send back to the lab. Be sure that the lid's closed good. You don't want the sample to leak in the mail.
Let's take a look at that swab snap again from a different angle.
Place the swab into there about to where it's at the black line. Now bend it until it snaps like that. Now replace the lid on the vial. Make sure it's secure and give it a little shake. Okay, so when we finished swabbing both cheeks and got our vials put back together, be sure the vials are inside the plastic envelope that has your test kit number on it. Place the release form that you've signed in the bag as well. Press the air out. Seal it up. Put it in the manila return envelope, see, with the family tree DNA. If you have an order form, also be sure that you put that in the envelope as well. It's got an adhesive seal label you can peel off here, and then close up. Put appropriate postage on here. Family Tree doesn't necessarily have the right postage for your country, so therefore be sure to check what the appropriate parcel is. This is a parcel, not a letter. And mail it back to Family Tree DNA, and you'll get your results online. Thank you very much.